Raid Motoblog. Let's ride. Let's go.
Well, Brad, this is Gray Ride Motoblog. So, bali, review tayo dito sa MIUI 125S natin. Bali, black gray yung kulay niya. FI na rin siya, fuel injected. Dito. Ayan. Ayan. Bagong ligo kasi si Mot Gray. So, tingnan natin yung panel. Ayan ang panel niya. Ayan. Okay. Meron na rin siyang idle. Yung stop and start system indicator light niya. Ayan. So, meron na yung button. Kaya ano ba yung stop and start system operation? That stops the engine automatically after a certain period of time when the vehicle is stopped. While the stop and start system indicator light is on to prevent noise, control exhaust emissions, and reduce fuel consumption. When the rider turns the throttle grip slightly, the engine restarts automatically and the vehicle starts up. Kaya gumagana lang to mga pups, mga bad, kapag yung napainit na yung engine nyo, yung umaandar na siya. And then kapag nasa stoplight kayo, pwede nyo siyang click, and then ilaw yan, and then mamatay yung engine, and then magbiblink. So hindi nyo na kailangan i-start pa ulit, kailangan lang i-grip lang tong throttle na to konti, and then on na yung engine, tapos balik nyo lang ito kapag ano na kayo. Consumption talaga siya kapag yung traffic o kaya yung nasa stoplight kayo, yun ang kinaganda nya, tipid sa gas, lalo na ito ay fuel injected, kaya talagang makakatipid. This is Gray Ride Motoblog. So testingin natin yung start system, stop and start system. Tingnan natin yung indicator. Yan. On natin. Yan. Lalabas yung green. Then, mamatay yung engine. Then, magbiblink yan. Kapag gusto nyo umandar yan, i-ano lang yung throttle. Yun. On na. Off. Okay. Yun. Tayo ulit natin mga pups. Mga pups, mga brad. Ito yung indicator. Stop and start system. Ito yung switch nya. off natin. Okay. Umilaw. Okay. Magbiblink. Namatay yung engine. Pero yung napansin nyo, yung headlight, hindi na mamatay, oh. Ganun pa rin. So, tingnan natin. Na-on na yung engine niya ulit. Patayin ulit natin, tapos try natin i-on and off. Andar muna natin mga pups. Ayan. Ayan. Medyo hindi na uminit yung engine kaya hindi na gumagana. Kaya sa mga nagbabalak kumuha ng MIUI 125, I guess this is the best. Take a look. Ito yung body. Ito yung ano niya, head. Yeah. Meron na rin siyang emblem. Ayan, may emblem siya. Ayan, makikita nyo, naglagay na rin ako dyan ng ano, ng bracket. Ng HRB bracket. And then, meron na rin tayong box. Ito yung tail light niya. Yung ano niya. Sa likod. Ayan. Ano pa meron sa MIUI 125? Naglagay na rin pala ako mga paps, mga bride. Kung makapansin nyo, meron tayong orasan. Meron ng time voltage. 2-in-1 na rin yan. Sa TDD. Yeah. So, meron na rin tayong CP holder. Meron, with charger na ito, mga paps, mga bride. Pakita ko sa inyo. I-review rin natin yan susunod. Pero ito yung CP. May inoon dito para bukas. Ito. Ito, mag-zoom. Ayan, nakita nyo? Ayan, off lang natin kasi. Dito na rin yung ano niya. Yeah. 70x90 ang front, 80x90 ang rear. Pero hindi yan yung naka-stock tayo niyan talaga. Kasha dito sa compartment natin. Let's see. Okay. Ganda naman siya kalaki. Ito yung mga lagayan natin ng tools at yung mga papeles. Okay, ayan. Ito pala yung lagayan ng baterya niya. Tingnan natin. Ayan. Lagayan ng tools. Tsaka take note, kasya naman itong bag kung ganito kaliit. Ayan, ganang kasya. Hindi katulad doon sa Miu Soul Eye, kasya yung helmet na half face. Pero dito hindi kasya. Napakabasahan.
Kung gusto nyo makita yung bagong labas ng PUI, dito sa description, click nyo lang.
Assumption pala na ito, yung kasya niya sa tank, yung full tank pala na ito ay nasa 4.2 liters or 4.5. Yan. Kaya, next vlog, ibablog natin kung ilang kilometers sa isang litro. Okay. Sa locking system naman, mga paps, mga bread. Kasi nyo, ito. Pag ilalock nyo yan, okay? Then, ito. Yan. Kapag nasa malayo kayo, pwede, pag, halimbawa, nasa parking kayo, nasa mall kayo, eh, hindi nyo makita itong motor nyo, pwede nyo siya i-click. Meron tong button. Yan. At meron siyang beeping sound. Yun. Kapag gusto niya ma-open yung pinaka-lock niya, kahit malayo kayo, press the button. Ayun. Testing ulit natin, malapitan. Ayun. Kaya may, paggabi yan, may makikita kayong light. White, violet na light. Kapag gina-open natin yan, sabi na rin yung under nitong time voltage na. Voltage na rin. Yan. Oh!
An automatic scooter in the Philippines makes a lot of sense. These convenient and affordable rides are them dozen on the streets of Manila for good reason. They let you beat the traffic as well as raising fuel costs. And when it comes to automatic scooters, Yamaha MIUI 125 is second only to its smaller brothers, the Yamaha Miu and Miu Sporty itself. The MIUI 125 was launched in late 2015. The S version was launched in late 2017. But there's more. The new looks of MIUI 125 and MIUI 125S was launched in 2018. Yes, it's new, with the intention of cornering the market, and the Yamaha has succeeded on the front immensely. With this scooter, one gets the ace of the automatic scooter at the affordable price that comes with a bit more power and striking looks than its smaller counterparts. The Yamaha MIU lineup has been in the market for over a decade now. Its extensive array of cheap, fuel-efficient, and easy-to-ride scooters has allowed to capture a wide market. There is something for everyone. The MIUI 125 has been aimed at the youth. This means that it gets slightly more aggressive styling. Approach the bike from the front and you cannot miss the big M surrounding the headlight. Approach it from the back and you are faced with another M shape created by the grab rails. Take a view from the side. You will immediately tell the difference between this and its smaller brothers. Its lines are sharper and more aggressive. The graphics look like tribal tattoos. There are slashes and bends. Even the meter panel looks contemporary and the exhaust adds muscles. Six different color option means there is something for everyone. It is not difficult to see why this scooter appeals to the youth so much. Practically, it's also given a high priority. Its dimension will fit rides for every shape and size with comfort. Handlebar position with respect to seat, keeping the ride comfortable. It comes with 10 liters under seat storage, which is long and deep, while it may be difficult to keep a full face helmet in. It is still pretty huge. The slim dimension and sub 100 kilogram weight make the scooter easy to maneuver in town. The ground clearance is enough to go over potholes without worry. It also comes with an integrated keyhole, shutter, and answer back system to locate the scooter in crowded car parks. These features makes this scooter a very good commuter. But a good commuter above all needs to score high on fuel economy. The engine in the MIUI 125 is fuel injected, 125cc, SOHC, single cylinder with 2 valves per cylinder. While there is no liquid cooling, it uses forced air to keep itself cool. Peak power of 7.0 kilowatts comes at 8,000 RPM and peak torque of 9.6 Nm. Is delivered at 5,500 RPM. There is enough torque to accelerate the bike at traffic stop launches and to overtake in city traffic. The fuel economy, however, is much more promising. Yamaha has used their acclaimed Blue Core technology to load their scooter with a lot of engine tech in order to keep its mileages high. So, while the scooter can easily reach 90 km/h, it still manage 45 km per liter on fuel average. The bike also comes with a fuel-saving stop-start system that shuts down the engine after it spends some time idling. The engine shutting smart standing stand is also standard, while a new one with the stop-start system can be bought of 74,900 or 70,900 for the one without it. But the new MIUI 125 and 125S is you can bought it for the price of 75,900 pesos and 72,900 pesos. Also, the used market is a good option. The scooter has not spent a long time in the market, so finding good examples should not be difficult. However, this bike is normally owned by youngsters and therefore don't see road use. Safe to say, look for the rudders and all-fitting body panels along the uneven paint finish for replaced body parts. Ask for the service records and verify the mileages claimed by the seller. Needless to say, take the scooter for the test ride. Look for the things like engine noise, vibration, noises from the brakes, and a brake distance itself. Take a mechanic or at least another MIU owner with you look to give the bike a once-over. Finally, ensure that the owner provides you with all the relevant documents, including registration, insurance, and owner proofs. Safe to say, you cannot go wrong with this scooter, whether it is old or new.